Hello dear students, I am assistant professor Roshali Ahir, and in today's session of fermentation technology part 2 we are going to learn about the industrial production of glutamic acid. Now glutamic acid, it is an amino acid, and the production of amino acid was started for the first time in the Japan in year 1908 when the scientist or the chemist Dr. K. Iddick, he was working on the flavoring component of kelp, and he found that after the acid hydrolysis and fractionation of the kelp, he discovered that one specific fraction was isolated which consisted of glutamic acid, and after neutralization with caustic soda, a specific delicious taste was developed to that kelp, and it was the birth of the use of monosodium glutamate as a flavoring agent. And in this session, we are going to study about this glutamic acid production in detail. Okay, so let's see the introduction about this. Now, basically, amino acids, as we all know, it is very important for the synthesis of protein. It is a building block of protein, and it plays a very important role in the metabolism process of the living organisms, whereas it has a very important role in the biological function as well as in the biochemistry and various industries. So the large scale production of these amino acid, it can be carried out by the use of different kinds of chemicals or else microorganisms. There are great interest have been developed in the peptide derivatives or chemotherapeutics, which have increased the importance of non-proteinogenic pure amino acids. Now, these amino acids, which are having a great importance in the biological functions, these amino acids, they can be produced by various methods like chemical synthesis, isolation by natural materials, or fermentation, or chemoenzyme methods can be utilized for the production of amino acids, which are very important as a nutrient, flavoring agent, or a starting material for various pharmaceutical, cosmetics, and other chemical production. So here we are going to focus on the production of amino acids, specifically glutamic acid and lysine. Your syllabus includes production of two types of amino acid. One is glutamic acid and second one is lysine. So in today's session, we are going to focus on the biosynthesis or the production of glutamic acid by using microorganisms with the help of fermentation process. Now, let's start with the glutamic acid. Glutamic acid is an alpha amino acid that is used in the biosynthesis of protein. As we have already mentioned earlier also, this glutamate or the glutamic acid was the first amino acid which was produced. And this first amino acid, it was produced by using Cornibacterium glutamicum. It contains, if we study the structure of glutamic acid here also in diagram, you can see the structure of glutamic acid. It contains alpha amino group, which is protonated. Here you can see the alpha amino group is present, whereas an carboxylic acid group is also present in the glutamic acid, as it is acid group, it contains carboxylic group. It is polar and negatively charged aliphatic amino acid. Generally, it is non-essential in humans because it can be synthesized inside the body. As glutamic acid, it can be synthesized inside the body of the humans. It is non-essential amino acid. Now, what are the applications of glutamic acids? Now, glutamic acid, it is basically used as a flavor enhancer in various food industries. During the production of different kinds of foods, to improve the flavor of that food material, glutamic acid is generally used, as well as it supplies different kinds of nutrients. So it is also used as a nutritional supplement. Then glutamic acid, it is also applied in various beverage industries. It increases the flavor of various soft drinks and wines. Then for the production of different kinds of cosmetics, generally it restores the hair, it increases the strength of hair. So for in the various cosmetics which are used to stop the hair loss or in the treatment of hair loss, that cosmetic acid includes glutamic acid in it, whereas it is also used as anti-aging agent, means it stops the wrinkles forming and it prevents the aging of that person. So this glutamic acid, it is generally used in various kinds of cosmetics to stop the hair loss and to stop the or to prevent the wrinkle formation. Whereas in different kinds of agricultural products and animal feed, as a nutrient supplement, glutamic acid is used as an additive in animal feeds. Whereas for the synthesis of different kinds of organic chemicals in various industries, glutamic acid is a chief raw material. So these are the applications of glutamic acid. Now we will start with the biosynthesis of glutamic acid. Up till now, we have only studied the general introduction about glutamic acid. In the next session, we will actually start with the production of glutamic acid by using microorganism. Thank you.